Hey, Evans. Hey, Jack. Thank you for your response. I appreciate you taking the time to respond to my video. Just curious, though, why do you disable ratings on your videos? I noticed you had 4 ratings, they were all 5 stars, and then you turned ratings off. Why would you do that? You do know that even if someone rates you negatively, it still boosts you. Do you know that? Having 5 stars doesn't help if there's only 4 ratings. You need multiple ratings. So if you had, like, you know, 500 ratings and they were all 1 star, you would still be at the most rated. Notice it doesn't say highest rated. Just curious, but something for you to think about. I leave it on, personally. I always do. You got 1,500 subscribers. Surely most of them are Christian. They would rate you pretty good. I got plenty of haters, too, and I still end up with, you know, 3 to 4 stars on almost all videos and 5 stars on many videos. Anyway, let's get to what you said. That's just my advice. You said, when or how did Jesus fool his disciples into believing that he was the Messiah? First, you're assuming that he existed. Second, you're assuming that he ever said that he was Messiah. And third, you really deleted out a lot of the other alternatives that I gave. Keep in mind that what my video was when people say, why would they die for a lie? I gave you multiple reasons of how it could have happened. But let's go with the direct answer to what you're asking. Let's assume Jesus did exist. Let's assume he did claim he was a Messiah. And let's assume that he did try and convince his disciples of such. When did it happen? When John the Baptist got executed. Did a video on this. You might want to check it out if you want deeper insight. But basically what it is that John the Baptist said that, the Messiah is coming in my lifetime. And then he died. So somebody had to step up. So, hey, here's Jesus. Oh, look, he's, here I am, I'm the Messiah. Ta-da! And so there he was. It started there. If any of the rest of it happened, that's where it started. Anyway, that's when. How did he do it? This is primitive man. They were pretty gullible. Okay, they were pretty easily fooled. They thought that demons made them sick. They didn't realize it was bacteria. I mean, these are not exactly highly advanced people we're talking about here, okay? They were pretty gullible. And if you don't believe that they were pretty gullible, then how do you explain all the other false religions that were out there? How did they all get fooled? Because they were gullible, okay? They would believe whatever you told them because they didn't know. Science wasn't even a thought at that point in time. I mean, you know, the science was this... Well, there was science, obviously, but the field of study to go into this and the scientific method had not developed to what it is, even remotely to what it is now. So they were pretty easily fooled because they were pretty uneducated. So they believed whatever you told them. Okay, then you talk about Paul's pre-Pauline creeds. And you talk about 1 Corinthians and where it tells about the story, which is Paul's writing, telling the story of the story that he professed. Circular reasoning, Jack. You're using the Bible to prove the Bible, using a writing of Paul, who I basically say invented Christianity. He tends to predate all the Gospels. It would appear that he made the whole damn thing up. Or he picked up on a current idea and expounded on it because he found a loophole that would pay him profit. And that's not profit, P-R-O-P-H-E-T, profit. But anyway, and then you said that, and Jesus told them to expect to be persecuted for their beliefs. Name me a religion that wasn't. Name me a religion that wasn't persecuted for their beliefs. There are other religions that were persecuted by the Jews for their beliefs. Pretty much all religions get persecuted for their beliefs. Why is that? Because none of them have any proof. They can't prove their claims, so other people don't believe them, and so therefore they think that they're wrong. Oh, but my invisible sky daddy is better than your invisible sky daddy, and so we must kill you now. That's how they get persecuted for their beliefs. Not a big fascinating claim there. It's just like when people talk about revelations and it says that there will be non-believers. There's always non-believers. There's always been non-believers. But anyway, did Jesus lie to them? Again, you assume that he existed. You assume that he ever said that, all the stuff I said at the very beginning. You said there's no reason to expect Jesus to have lied to them. Now, you're assuming a lot right there. He made them all give up all their personal belongings. Doesn't this sound like a cult to you? I mean, seriously. Why would David Koresh lie to all of his people? Why would he do that? Why would the Heaven's Gate cult lie to all their people? Why did Charles Manson lie to his people? You know, you repeatedly dismiss the comparisons, and yet everything you bring up still fits. Where was the evidence to justify the claims of Manson and Koresh? Where's the evidence to justify the claims of Jesus? Oh, you tell us. You said that he said that he was going to be crucified and raised from the dead, and he did, and the evidence is that that Christianity exists. Well, let me remind you. Islam exists. So does that prove that the Prophet Muhammad also ascended to heaven? Does that prove that the Quran was delivered to him by God simply because the religion exists? Does Hinduism exist, and that proves that it's real because the religion exists? There's a lot of religions that exist. There were religions before Christianity. There's some that came after. The fact that the religion exists doesn't prove anything other than there is a religion. That's it. You talked about the strong oral tradition that we don't have today. May I remind you that I am talking to you now. Original followers were still alive when this was being preached. Okay. You assume that the original followers ever existed? You assume that they had cable TV and could find out that this guy was lying about them? I mean, let's face it, there was no mass media to know that someone was making up a story about them. They had no way, and even if they did find out, they had no way to tell the masses that, hey, wait, don't listen to him, he's telling a lie, that's not what we said. You're making a lot of assumptions, Jack. I mean, just think about that. I'm not telling you to change your mind and believe me, but just think, your logic is flawed. They didn't have the means to go on CNN and issue a counterpoint. It didn't happen. There was no internet to do a response video. You know what I mean? You said, why would these people sincerely believe in Christianity? Why did the rest of them sincerely not believe? People believe stupid stuff all the time. I know that you're a supporter of evolution. There are people who still don't, despite all the evidence. They still don't. So why don't they believe? You know, the idea of, oh, well, there's evidence, so that must be why they believe. No. There are people who believe other things that make no sense. You know, going back to the other question, where was the evidence? Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm skipping ahead. I'll come back to that. All right, so was Jesus a liar or was he crazy? Again, go back to the first thing I said. I never said he existed. I never said that he said that he was the Messiah. The story got exaggerated is what I tend to most side with, but there's no proof for any of it. All right, now to the other one. So if the evidence didn't show up to support the claim, why did they follow it? Why does anyone else follow any other religion? Why did the Manson girls follow Charles Manson? Why did the Branch Davidian follow David Koresh? Why did the Heaven's Gate cult follow them? I mean, where was the evidence for them to support all this? I mean, these people, they didn't wait and get persecuted later. They didn't go back to their jobs. They said, okay, I'm going to castrate myself and then kill myself so that I can get on the comet. And they all thought it was perfectly reasonable. And need I remind you, they had more than 12 followers. So, your 12 disciples don't seem to stand up to my examples that I use. But, hey, again, thank you for taking the time to watch the video and watching this one as well.